very unfortunate that the Honorable Chief Minister, who is the leader of the House of this August House, has misled this August House and subsequently the people of the state by giving wrong information. Now, how he has misled this August House? Because in the PPA, there is no mention of rupees 11 crore per month to be paid to NTPC. There is no mention of 133 crore of rupees to be paid to NTPC per year. And there is no mention of the amount of 3,325 crore of rupees to be paid in a period of 25 years. If the MECL is not a position to pay or draw the power from the NTPC, the NTPC can always divert the power supply and the share of MECB to any other bulk purchaser within 60 days of billing. If the MECL is not willing to purchase power from the NTPC, or it is not being able to pay the dues, then there is again exit clause in the agreement. In para 12, the second paragraph, we can see, in the event the functions of MECB are recognized and all this PPA is assigned to private organization, agency, partly or wholly the successor organization, the assignee shall ensure alternative payment security mechanism to the satisfaction of NTPC before assignment of this agreement to the private organization, agencies. In the event such satisfactory arrangements is not met, NTPC shall have the option to terminate this agreement. In the event of termination of this agreement, MECB shall be liable and continue to pay the capacity charges each month till firm arrangement of sale of MECB's share with alternate customers substituting the MECB is tied up.
Sir, I have with me the NTPC billing amount for the month of 4th of March 2021. And here, the billing amount says capacity charges, which is fixed charge, 11.86 crores. This is the current bill that we have received from NTPC, which says 11.8 crores. So this is the number that I'm referring to, that we are paying 11.8 crores today. Now, if you again further go back into the entire history of this, apart from the 100 crores that we cleared a few months back to NTPC through the Atmanirbhar loan, we still have an outstanding due of 531 crores. So we have already paid 100 crores, which was part of the running bill for 1 year, which we had taken. Post that, we stopped taking. And from that time till today, there is a 531 crore outstanding due to NTPC. And all of these are fixed charges. All of this is fixed charge, along with, of course, penalties and surcharges also in it. So where is the question of misleading the House? These are facts right in front of you to see that 11.8 crores is the bill that NTPC has given us. 531 crores is the amount of the fixed charges that the NTPC is charging us, along with the penalty and the late charges that are there. Where is the question of misleading? These are facts for everybody to see. Now you go to clause number 11, sir. What does clause number 11 say? That the effective date and duration of agreement, this agreement shall come into force from the date of signing of this agreement for all purposes and intent, and shall remain operative up to completion of 25 years from the date of commercial operation of last unit of the station, unless it is specifically extended. Now, sir, here itself, it clearly mentions that this agreement is going to go on for 25 years more from the last date of commission, which was 2019. Now, if you were to multiply this amount of 11 crores and multiply it by 12 months and multiply that by 25 years, it comes up to 3,000 crores. So therefore, it's based on the current facts that are available with us, which is based on this bill that the NTPC has given us of 11 crores. Where is the question of misleading the House? I'm basing my argument on facts. Further, in the agreement itself, it mentions about fixed charges. Honorable member himself has read those clauses out. So therefore, I will not go into it further. But he also has admitted that there are fixed charges that are applicable there. So again, so there's no question of misleading the House. I've based it on the facts that we have with us today and the agreement that was signed in 2007. We are paying 11.8 crores today to NTPC. We are going to have to pay this for the next 25 years. And if this amount continues, we will be paying 3,000 plus crores if we do not draw any power. Now, Honorable Member mentioned that the clause says that during the period of regulation and diversion of power, till the power is reallocated to other bulk power consumers. So for past 3 years, nobody has been willing to buy this power from NTPC. So now, yes, if we find a consumer, that's great. We will not have to pay this. But because the rates are high, no other power or no other consumer is willing to pay. So therefore, today, in effect, for the past many, many years, we are having to pay this amount, and the dues, as I mentioned, sir, has now piled up to 531 crores on the fixed charges, on the other penalties that are there on the fixed charges, and the late payment fees on the fixed charges. So therefore, Honorable Member mentioned that we need to reallocate this to other consumers. So we can't find, and for many years, we're not being able to find any consumer in this. So very interestingly, Honorable Member has mentioned about Clause 12. Sir, I need to clarify, if you were to read Clause 12 clearly, you would really realize that what Honorable Member is mentioning is completely the other way around. Let me read it again, sir, the second paragraph. In the event the functions of MECL now, are reorganized and or with PPA is assigned to private organizations, agencies, partly or wholly, the successor organizations and assignees shall ensure alternative payment security mechanism to the satisfaction of NTPC before assignment of this agreement to the private organization and agencies. That means without NTPC's clearance, we will not be able to go ahead with that. It doesn't mention exit clause again. It just mentions about the fact that if the events of functioning of MECB are reorganized. Number two, in the event, this is the most important part, sir, in the event such satisfactory arrangement is not made, NTPC shall have the option to terminate this agreement. Not MECL, only NTPC will have the power to terminate the agreement. Very clearly mentioned out here. So isn't this a lopsided agreement in that sense? And further, sir, if you read the last part, which is even more amazing, sir, that in the event of the termination of this agreement, which means NTPC, if they agree to terminate. So in the event of termination of this agreement, MECEL, because it's written MESEB. So in the event of termination of this agreement, MECL shall be liable to continue to pay the capacity charges each month. Which means that if NTPC decides to terminate this agreement, we still have to pay NTPC fixed charges. So where's the question of termination of the agreement? And it says, of course, liable to continue till firm arrangements of sale of MECL share with alternative customers substituting MECL is tied up with. So again, the same condition that till you don't find a new consumer, NTPC can terminate this agreement. And even after they terminate this agreement, which means all the terms and conditions should be nullified. But no, even after the termination of the agreement, MECL still has to pay the fixed charges. So this is what we are trying to stress on and saying that due diligence should have been done. Now, Honorable Elo mentioned in his argument that time, saying that that these are standard documents and formats and agreements that cannot be changed. So this is incorrect. There's no standard format that is made. There are discussions and negotiations that take place between the different supplier and the generation company, and whether it's a thermal power project, there'll be different terms and conditions. Whether it's terms and conditions with a hydropower company, it'll be different terms and conditions. So saying that there's a standard and we cannot negotiate in that is incorrect. It depends on the negotiation and discussions that take place. Now, so imagine in 2016, when the CRC had come out with the different rates, even at that point in time, government of Meghalaya could have taken up this issue with CERC, but it was taken up with government of India, which is not the correct forum. The redressal and the appeal has to be made to CERC, which was not done. Maybe if we had done it at that point in time, maybe the rates would have been far better for us. So therefore, sir, all these points that the honorable members are mentioning, I have laid down clearly where I'm coming out with these numbers. These are facts in front of everybody to see. Whether it's the 11 crores which we are paying right now, and if this continues for the next 25 years, it will reach 3,000 crores. So where's the question of misleading? Whether it's the 25 years, clause 11 clearly says that it will be 25 years this agreement will continue. Fixed charges, we have to pay. Whether we take power or not, we have to pay fixed charges. Clause 2.2.6 says it. Here in the clause 12, it clearly says that the exit clause is in favor of NTPC, where they can exit at any time and yet impose the fixed charge on us without having this particular agreement on board. So it is completely an agreement which is not in favor of government of Meghalaya and MECL. And the point we were trying to make is that the genesis of this problem of NTPC started with that particular agreement. And this is what we stand by even today. The points that I've mentioned and clarified today to you are clear. Facts are here. I've showed the bills also that we have paid. So there is no question of misleading the House. I could be continuously saying the same thing about the opposition also, of how they have misled. But that is not what we're trying to prove out here. What we're trying to prove out here is that we cannot have a blame game and just say that the current government and the current power minister are incompetent and they must resign, and the only way to resolve this issue is if both of them are removed. This is not the solution and the idea in the discussion that we should be having. The point when the genesis of this started in 2007, you must realize that you were very much part of it at that time. So how can you just simply point a finger and blame us? That is what our point that we're trying to make, sir. So therefore, in the interest of healthy debate, I would urge the honorable member not to bring out these points. He knows the facts. I've shown all the facts to him. And I would like to urge him that he can withdraw this particular privilege motion, sir. So with these few points, I have clarified all the points that have been mentioned out here. And with these few words, sir, I resume my seat. Thank you, sir.
Government and the responsibility associated with government is a continuous process. We refer to each government as government of Meghalaya. And the responsibility, because each of the successive government has to shoulder the responsibility in continuity, any agreement signed by the government at any point of time is passed on to the government, because it's a question of the onus of responsibility of each one of the signatory. And in case of any agreement between the government, that means it's the government. Mr. Speaker, sir, I think I have referred to Rule 162. I have referred to Rule 162, and we are only required to adhere to the rules of procedure and conduct of business.
Even me also, I read this rule 162, as per the rules, but it seems the LO he started, again, in addition to whatever the mover has explained, he wanted to, again, justify more or raise more issues on this. So, Mr. Speaker, sir, I leave it to your
powers. Mr. Speaker, sir, rule is very clear. You have to allow.
2 minutes, please stop.
And what does it say? In case of the outstanding dues, in case of the required letter of credit or any other agreed payment security mechanism is not maintained as per the agreement, the generating company transmission licensee, as the case may be, may serve a notice of for regulation of power supply on defaulting entity for reducing drawal schedule in case of generating company. When we don't pay the payment, there will be sudden stoppage. NIPCO has resorted to regulation. Has NIPCO not resorted to regulation? We have paid fixed charges. Does the Chief Minister want to say that we have not paid fixed charges to NIPCO when the regulation was invoked in the event of our default? This is a procedure, Mr. Speaker. Sir. Okay. That's why we are saying that please don't distort the provision of the law.
Going into agreement after agreement, yeah, sir.
We have discussed enough on this.
It is long issue, sir.
I have heard from...
It is long issue.
I have heard from you.
Sir, let me just ask the honourable member, can you deny that we have to pay 11.8 crores today? Can you deny it? You can't.
Not written.
Can you deny? I have got the bill with me right here. We are paying 11.8 crores per month. Can you deny it? Can you deny that this will go on for the next 25 years? Can you deny the fact that there are fixed charges? Can you deny it? You can't deny it, sir. These are facts. We are paying right now and we will continue to pay for the 25 years. This is my point, sir. Now we go into agreement after agreement, sir. We can call all the legal experts.
There are lots of agreements, sir.
The petitioner should be given time. I think you have given him
time. No, I have given him time. You have given him his course of...
You have given him time, Mr. Speaker, sir.
Yeah.
And this 11 crore,
so may I know the amount
they are paying is because you are not drawing the power.
Please take a seat. Please take a seat. May I know the mind of the mover? Would you like to withdraw or not? The House has heard both sides.
Mr. Speaker, sir, if after my submission, Chief Minister has given his own clarification.
Yeah.
After hearing to his clarification, I have some other
thing. Are you satisfied or not?
Based on that.
Are you satisfied or not with that reply from the Chief Minister?
I am not satisfied.
You decide not to withdraw? You decide not to withdraw?
Without getting any satisfactory reply and just deviating from the actual, the fact, how can I be willing to withdraw my privilege motion? So I will not withdraw, Mr. Speaker, sir.
Okay.
As 62 may be followed.
As per Rule 163 of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of the Business, the motion of privilege, a breach of privilege raised by Senate M. Sangma, will have to be decided, back-lived, and taken into consideration by the House. The question is that the motion raised by Senate M. Sangma, MLA, or the question of breach of privilege be taken into consideration by the House. Those who are for the motion say aye.
Aye.
Those who are against say no.
No.
The noes have it, and the motion on the question of breach of privilege raised by Zenit M. Sangma is rejected by the House.
Sir, Mr. Speaker, so one point under Rule 300. Again, I would like to bring. Refer to the Rule 173. The Rules 173 says groundless complaint. In case the House finds a charge of breach of privilege groundless, it may order the payment of an amount not exceeding 500 as a cost to the party charged by the party complaining. Sir, I would like, therefore, to recommend that the complainant be charged 500 rupees.